The Diagnostic and Statistical Manual, called the DSM, is a listing of mental disorders and provides definitions for each of them that are meant to guide diagnosis and therefore to influence treatment planning. The system in its current form started in 1980, before the drug companies were a major factor in selling illnesses in order to sell pills. And the system is far too loose in its definitions. So what may have made sense then, when the biggest problem in the country was underdiagnosis, no longer makes sense now when we're suffering from overdiagnosis promoted by drug company advertising. So the diagnostic system needs to be changed in the direction of narrowing, because currently it's way too loose and way too easy for people who have the normal stresses and aches and pains of everyday life to get diagnosed as having a mental disorder and get treated with a pill. The biggest problem in terms of overdiagnosis caused by the DSM system comes with depression and anxiety. Sadness and worries are very adaptive. People who can't feel sad can't love and get attached to things. People who can't worry do stupid things, puts them in danger. We can feel sad, we can feel anxious, because these helped our ancestors survive. We shouldn't confuse normal sadness and normal anxiety with mental disorder. And that line has been terribly blurred. So that many people who present to the GP feeling badly about having lost a job or feeling worried about how they're going to support their family, they're diagnosed as having a mental disorder and given a psychiatric pill. Much better to give them counseling, to have watchful waiting, to normalize their sadness or anxiety, because most people are going to get better on their own.